The sundial is an ancient Chinese device for measuring time, which, from the first unification of China, came to symbolize the impartiality and fairness of the emperor's rule. The sundial was composed of a granite disc upon which evenly spaced markings had been carved, representing the 12 shurgens, a unit of time equivalent to 2 hours. At the center of the disc stood a vertical needle, and its body would cast a long shadow on sunny days. As the sun made its way across the sky, the needle's shadow would travel through the different markings on the disc, providing an accurate measure of the passage of time. However, how could time be measured on cloudy days or during the night? At the Horologe exhibit in the Imperial Palace Museum in Beijing, we find a very peculiar national treasure, a copper clepsydra produced in 1799 AD. This clepsydra's appearance resembles a tall wooden building. Almost 6 meters high, its interior separated into 3 vertical levels, each containing a rectangular copper pot known as a water-pouring pot. At the base lies a round pot that juts outwards, known as the water-receiving pot. Within it lays a bronze figurine whose hands are grasping the clepsydra's needle. When put into action, the instrument depends exclusively on the outwards flow of water from the mouth of each water-pouring pot. As the water flows gradually from the water-pouring pots and into the round water-receiving pot, the needle on the copper figurine floats upwards, marking the 12 two-hour shurgens with astounding precision. Beginning at noon, when the uppermost copper pot would be filled to the brim with water, it would flow through the clepsydra for a full day and a full night, within a margin of error of only about 10 minutes. China has a long history with water clocks. The early experiments with primitive clepsydras, thanks to the relentless efforts and investigations of the Chinese people, developed into an accurate instrument as this copper clepsydra. Ancient records tell how the latest clepsydras can be dated back to the spring and autumn period. Their most basic, these consisted of a water part and marked staff upon which ancient farmers depended in order to keep track of the times during plowing and seeding of their fields. However, these primitive clepsydras consisted only of one water-pouring pot, which made their measure of time highly unreliable. In order to increase their accuracy, the number of pots was increased, one at each level, flowing into the following one in order to ensure the continuous and stable speed of the water flow at the last level. By the Song Dynasty, an additional element was added to increase the accuracy of this clepsydra. Known as the dividing water pot, this extra level would receive the water that flowed out of an upper opening in the pouring water pot should it exceed its desired quantity, thus acting as a drainage system that went one step further in ensuring the stability of the flow and hence the reliability of the clepsydra. From the Ming and Qing dynasties onwards, chiming clocks became in vogue. By the time of Emperor Qianlong of the Qing dynasty, the imperial palace would switch to a chiming clock for keeping time. As with the sundial, the clepsydra would then move from the practical to the symbolical, representing the unification of all under heaven by the emperor's rule.